Hey, East Oakland Chef Armond Lanesse. You know, I was thinking back earlier today about some burritos, and one of the best burritos that I had came from La Fortuna. It was a grocery store, and in the back it had a burrito shop. And man, them burritos were on hit. I used to get this lengua burrito. And man, I just been thinking about it. So I figured I'm gonna go ahead and put one together. And while I'm putting it together, y'all can watch and learn, and then y'all can make your own super lengua burritos. And I'm sorry, not trying to take any business from the trucks, but it's gonna save you some money. So we're gonna start off first with all these items that I got from Walmart. And of course, gotta have some cilantro, got bell pepper, got some jalapenos, and onion. Well, if I can get that out the bag, got an onion right there. And of course, gotta have the flour tortillas, which is the 8-pack giant burrito. Gotta get your cheese. Got some mozzarella cheese going on there. And I like verdes. You can use a red sauce. It really depends on your liking of what type of sauce you want. But I like a little verdes, and I'm going to dice this one up a little bit with jalapenos and onions. And then, of course, you got to have some seasonings. Taco seasonings are pretty much a general spice for all your Latin cooking, outside of having to get each one independently, the cumin, the garlic powder, the onion powder, chili powder, et cetera, you get it all in one pack. So you can flavor up everything that you need. I'm gonna flavor up the rice with this, and I'm also gonna use some of it when I start to cook the main ingredient, tongue. Look at that tongue packed up. Tongue is $9 a pound. So when you work with it, you want to make sure that you're going to have it together and you're going to do it right. And I'm going to show you how to do that. So we're going to swing this thing open first. Let me open up my knife case. Pull out my knife. We're going to open this packet up. Swing that packet up. We're gonna open this thing, take that little bloody sun out. Ah! Look at it's dripping with blood. There you go. That's gonna be our tongue. This is how we're gonna start. Ah! What if you had a tongue that big? Would that be something? Oh! Kind of look like throwing up or something. So that's how we're gonna start. And look at that slime of goo going. So, that's the tongue. Now, we're going to get you down where you can see me putting all this stuff together. We're going to take it another level, put you closer to the cooking process here at the East Oakland Chef Armond's Kitchen. So, the first thing we're going to need to do before we start braising our tongue, we're going to take a whole onion. Next up now is going to be the cilantro. I'm going to use the bottoms too, since they're going to be in a braise, but I am going to take some of the top off and do a real fine cut on it, because I want to add some of this cilantro to our little bowl, which we're going to add our salsa to. So we've got cilantro, we've got fresh jalapenos, and we've got fresh onions. Always like some, now if you're gonna go ahead and get store-bought salsas, which is fine, it's totally up to you, it's whatever you like. And most times it's a little more economical and definitely time-saving, because there's a lot of time you gotta put into creating a great salsa. But, you know, you can soup those up just by adding some fresh ingredients to them. Just like we did with the cilantro, the onions, and the peppers. We're going to spruce that up. All right. So now that we got all the ingredients cut up, we're gonna now put that tongue into our braising liquid that's also gonna contain the chili powder. I'm gonna add a little spice to it, and we're gonna have the onions and peppers and all that good stuff. Okay, now we're going to add the tongue to our bell peppers, jalapenos, and onions. We're gonna mix that up a little bit. Then we're gonna put that big tongue right there. Look at that. Look at that tongue, ladies. I tell you, don't be afraid of it now. We're gonna put some of that, cover that up. And then we're gonna add some liquid to that, just some water, some plain water to this. Now I've got a bowl, which is probably a couple cups. We're gonna put about three more bowls because we wanna get this filled up to about right there. All right, so now we're gonna make our Spanish rice. And this is a shortcut rice. Please believe me, this isn't true Spanish rice, but it's a quick rice. It's a quick one. So I take some jasmine rice, open that sucker on up, and I'm gonna fill this about a quarter of the way with rice. Just a quarter of the way, and that's almost about quarter bag. And then we're gonna take some more of the Walmart spice, and we're gonna add this spice to the rice. And not all of it. You're not gonna put it all, because if you put it all, it makes the rice real sticky and makes it very difficult to cook, because it's got flour and stuff inside that seasoned pack mix. So about half. And then we're gonna take and we're gonna submerge the rice. What I do, I normally put finger in and at the top of the rice underneath, and then I put my finger on the top of the rice, and my thumb lines up with the water line. It's a perfect amount of water. I'm just gonna add just a dash more. And then we're gonna swish that around a little bit, let those seasonings get to the bottom and mingle in with the rice where they do their little dance. Da 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 dee da 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 dee da da. Well, that's just my, you know, whatever. But anyway, we got it mixed now. We're gonna put the top on it, and we're gonna let this rice cook. Now I took that salsa verdes that we bought from the store, and I emptied it into this bowl, which I had the jalapenos, the fresh cilantro, the fresh onions, and then I added some chili powder, and I added a little bit of that Cajun seasoning. Got those two. And you flavor it to your taste. You like a lot of chili powder, add a lot of chili powder to it. You don't like a lot of chili powder, add less. Same with the Cajun seasoning. If you like it bold and savory and a little salty, go ahead and add a lot to it. And if you don't, just add a little bit just to enhance the flavor. Now, if I had a lime, I would add a little lime juice to it, but it was flavorful enough. Let's give it a try here. Mmm. Man, that is good. Damn. So that's our verdes. Lay it off this and see what we got. Don't you like my light blue towel? Woo! Yes! Some heat coming out of there. As you see, we got the foil. Okay, we've just pulled the tongue out of the oven. I have this little foil barrier right there. I kind of hold some of the steam in. And whoa, look at that sucker. Mmm. Very tender. Oh man, look at that thing. And it's all in this braising liquid now. All that good thick fluid we're gonna blend down and tighten up. And we're gonna use that almost like a natural jus. So we're gonna take our tongue from that braising fluid, and we're gonna place it into this pan right there. Isn't that gorgeous? Look at that. Man, that's gonna be delicious. Some goodness is going down. So now that we got the tongue completely done, the skin has to come off. Now you can't eat that part. That's part of the tongue you rather not deal with. So as you see, I'm gonna take my fork. I'm gonna kind of stir it around. I don't want this to pop back on me though, either. So that peels right off. I'll set that on top of that foil. Oh man, that's all the goodness in there. That's when you know you've got it completely done. When that tongue just flows off of it with no resistance. No fight. Let's get up underneath there. You want to kind of twist it. I don't want to lose too much of that good meat on there. So I'm going to go with my hands. Oh man, that looks good. There we go. So that peels right off. That skin pulls off easy like that. Look at that. Yes. Get a little bit of that underneath. The rest is all tender. Oh, gosh. Hellfire. I'll spin a little bit of that back end off. That's still got a little tightness on it. Yeah, yeah, that is, oh man, that's it. That's everything. That is absolutely delicious. We'll look on this back end here. See a little bit. So we got all the skin. It's all the skin. And now we're left with just the tongue. Awesome. Awesome. Now there we go. That's our baby. Nice. Very nice. All right, now it's time to hook this burrito up. We're gonna warm our tortilla up. Out here on the tortilla skillet. We're gonna lay it over here. We're gonna put some refried beans down. Now these are store-bought, real easy and quick. This is that rice we made earlier with the taco seasoning, which is our Spanish rice. We got that. We're gonna add some cheese in the center. I like some cheese, that mozzarella cheese we got. Then we're gonna add that tongue. Oh man, damn. It's better than a truck. Look at that. Loaded down. Then that salsa, that verdes that we made. Now you can go ahead at this point and add your sour cream. You can add a different type of cheese. You can do whatever you want at this point in time. Because now we are done, close to eating. So we're going to take this big sucker. I'm going to close the edges. Pull that back in, and I'm going to roll that sucker. Look at that. Damn. That's going to be damn good eating right there, I'll tell you what. Let's pull this on down. That's heavy. That's a heavy burrito. That's pretty good eating right there.
Hey, East Oakland Chef Armond Lanesse just want to say thank you for checking out the video. Beef tongue burrito, just like the truck over there on Fruitvale, or just like the restaurant I used to eat at called La Fortuna, deep in the East. I know your burrito should be looking like this. That is for real. Man, it takes me back. Can you see that?